Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us for our Harlow College Open event. I'm Sam, I work for marketing, and I will be overseeing this open event today. And also in the background is my colleague Jasmine, who will be helping me with that. Delivering the first part of your open event today will be our hospitality and catering team. How this webinar will work is our presenters will share their information with you. They can't see you, but you should be able to see them, alongside any information they wish to share on screen. Our presenters and other attendees can't hear you. However, you will be able to ask questions throughout the webinar using the Q&A feature. If you're using a computer, this will be at the bottom of your screen. If you're using a mobile device, tap the screen and this will appear at the top. Someone will either answer your questions live or answer it on the Q&A feed. Ask your questions as we go along, and we will save some time at the end of the subject presentations to answer as many as we can live. Please be aware that your name will appear next to your question, but you can click Ask Anonymously to remove this. We are recording this webinar and you will receive an email with a link to the recording. This will also be available on the Harlow College website. I'm now going to hand you over to our Head of Academy, Alison, for our hospitality and catering open event. Don't forget to send in your questions using the Q&A feature.
Hello, good evening. My name is Alison Armitage and I'm Head of Academy for the Leisure and Arts. With me is Stuart Smith, who's the Manager of Hospitality and Catering, and he's going to be answering your questions this evening. Next slide, please. This presentation is for hospitality and catering curriculum. So, as you can see on the slide, we have some potential careers for our students who come to the college in the hospitality area. We encourage our students to be ambitious, and our past students have certainly done that. They have gone on to work with top chefs and win international competitions, which have included Gordon Ramsay's Commis Chef of the Year, and two past students have done that. A member of the British Olympics team, where a student won a bronze medal, and International Salon Culinaire, where we've had various winners, as well as working in prestigious venues such as the House of Commons, the Radisson Blue, Patisserie Valerie, Down Hall, and several Michelin-starred restaurants over the past few years. A majority of our students entered the hospitality industry once they finished their programme with us. Next slide, please. We are very passionate about giving our students every advantage they need to flourish in a hospitality role. We offer state-of-the-art kitchens and a fully licensed training restaurant, which is open to the public, that replicates the skills required in the industry. We have experienced tutors who bring their own stories of their experiences working in the diverse hospitality industry themselves. There have been, for the last few years, a shortage of qualified chefs in the UK. And by the time you finish your programme with us, there is a very good chance that COVID epidemic will be behind us. And as a qualified chef, your career can begin. Next slide, please. So, course levels and progression. Our Level 1 MVQ multi-skilled programme is ideal for those students who require a more supported route through their training. There are no practical exams, but students are observed whilst working in our training restaurant and kitchen, as well as in the catering kitchen that supplies freshly cooked food to our students on campus. They complete a portfolio which demonstrates their skills and knowledge in both the kitchen and restaurant. The final overall grade will be a pass. Entry requirements are an interest in the hospitality industry, as well as 4 GCSEs or equivalent, 2 at grade 1 or above, or 2 at grade 2 and above. Our Level 2 VRQ programme covers both kitchen larder, which we mean meat, poultry, stock, sauces, fish, vegetables, rice, pulses, etc., and patisserie, such as cakes, pastries, bread, and other fermented goods. There are several practical exams through the year, with 2 longer practical exams in May and June. Alongside this, you will do short answer tests and assignment work. Your final overall grade will be a pass, merit, or distinction. Entry requirements are that you have a passion for cooking and 4 GCSEs are equivalent, two at grade two or above, and two at grade three or above. All students who do not gain a GCSE grade four or above in English and maths will need to continue to study these with retake options in November and June. This is mandatory and is part of the funded study programme you enrol onto. Next slide, please. Progression and beyond. Our MVQ pathway can take our students onto MVQ level two, food production and cooking, and ultimately onto our MVQ three. Some students also transfer over to the VRQ pathway. Our VRQ pathway will take our students onto VRQ three. We offer two standalone programs that alternate each year. 1 year is kitchen and larder. So if you start with us in 2021, you will do kitchen and larder in 2022. And then the following year, you will do a 1 year patisserie and confectionery in 2023. And a majority of our students stay on to do the 2 years at level three. We also offer a level three in event management at our Stansted Airport College, which students can progress onto if they get a merit grade on their VRQ2. Next slide, please. So course content. All programmes at level one and level two have similar core units as shown on the table, on the slide ahead of you. There is safe working practices, there's food hygiene, there's safety, learning to use equipment and knives, as well as different cooking methods and different commodities. Cooking competitions we also use and are a good way of preparing our students for when they go for a trial shift when going for full or part-time work. It puts them under pressure that they may experience when trying to prove their skills and knowledge. We also are asked to do a variety of events on and off campus, which we're asked to cater for, the largest being the Children's Christmas Party in December. The event is a hot Christmas lunch for around 900 special needs children. And every year we take our students from both campuses to completely run the front of house food service. And with our event management students as supervisors running their own 60 to 70 cover sections with their own staff. Some of our chefs also work in the kitchen alongside the contract caterer. It sounds daunting, but the students always rise to the challenge and provide a wonderful experience for the children, and it's often used as an assessment opportunity. Next slide, please. So, a typical day at Harlow College. We start at 9:30 and 1:30 in the afternoon with 3 hour sessions, either in theory or practical. And then the rest of the week could be a part-time job in the hospitality industry or doing some further study, and remember to give yourself a time for a little rest. However, be prepared for the 5 hour shifts in the training restaurant and kitchen. You do get breaks, but we're trying to replicate what you will experience in an industry. Any tips the students receive in the training restaurant are used towards subsidized trips. Next slide, please. So work-related learning. As mentioned earlier, students who do not achieve a grade four in their maths and English will need to retake at college, but we also embed maths and English into all our lessons, both theory and practical. Students do work experience. This is sometimes a full week or it's a couple of days each week and will be in the hospitality industry. We have weekly tutorials that cover many topics that raises issues such as Black History Month and this week, Remembrance Week. Students have regular one-to-one meetings with their learner mentors and discuss their individual learner plan and their progress. We use our industry contacts to share their experiences and the expectations they want to see when employing staff. We encourage our students to gain part-time roles in hospitality, but not too many hours that would affect their program at college, but provide some downtime also. Many employers contact us to fill vacancies for full and part-time roles, and we display them on our jobs board. Students have also picked up part-time work through guest speakers and visits. We use guest speakers in the final VRQ practical exams, so they see the quality of the students we are producing and the skills they have. There are extracurricular clubs that take place in the college, such as football, there's bands. Next slide, please. So some examples of students' work. The first slide and the third slide shows the children's Christmas party, and you can see it's a very large venue, but there are happy smiling faces in the first slide of the students who are working that event last year. Over on the far right, you can see the students. They're on the Cambridge food tour, which they normally do in induction week, where they get to try all different food and open their eyes to what's available in the hospitality industry. And the other photos are completed products the students have produced, and also some of them working. Next slide, please. Facilities. We have state-of-the-art facilities at the college, and you can see on the far right is our training restaurant, which the public can come into. It's a fully licensed restaurant. And then the middle slide is the students working in the kitchens. And then you can see the kind of food that you could eat if you came to our Skylight restaurant. And we do encourage parents to come and see their sons, daughters working in the restaurant or the kitchen. When you're in the kitchen, you will be on camera, and so you will be able to be seen by guests in the restaurant. Next slide, please. Technology. We are proud to be an Apple Distinguished College, and all students receive an iPad which needs to be charged and ready for every lesson. We use a variety of apps to support our delivery and enhance our student experience. You will need to pay a £50 deposit for your iPad, charger and lead. These must be in good condition to allow your deposit to be returned to you at the end of the year. There is financial support available to help with those deposits. Next slide, please. Course costs. Well, you can imagine working in hospitality, you're going to need chef's uniform and also a uniform for the restaurant. As chef's uniform, you will be given an order form at enrolment, which will include a pack of knives. We have lockers at the college that the students can store their personal belongings in, as well as their knives, because we do not want them walking around with their knives outside college. Uniforms must be clean and worn correctly for each lesson, as we have outlets that sell food to the public, so we have unannounced visits from the Environmental Health. We want to retain our 5 stars that we've worked very hard to achieve year after year. Next slide, please. Our top tips. Have a keen interest in hospitality and catering, and show that when you come to your interview. Tell us what you watch on the television, what you cook at home, what magazines you read, and also what social media you use and what apps you follow. Be ambitious. Don't just think, oh, I just want to work at McDonald's. Think of somewhere else that you can work that will actually give you a lot more interest. Commit yourself to your studies and plan for an exciting future in the hospitality industry. We are the second largest industry in the country. We might not be very good at the moment, but we will bounce back, and you will have an amazing time because it's so diverse. Always dress smartly. Your next employer may be one of our regular visitors to the college. Research different jobs in hospitality that may interest you. Think of progression and where you want to be in 5-10 years time. Dare to dream big. Hospitality is global and the opportunities are endless. Work hard, have fun, believe in you, and always be the best version of yourself. Next slide, please. Whilst you're at college, you may need some support, and we have 3 different areas that can do that. The Star Agency, they have admissions as part, are based in the Star Agency, and they're the people, when you complete your application form, you will be dealing with. They also offer career advice, work experience, financial and travel information. Our amazing safeguarding team are there to support our students if they need support with their own safety and well-being, and they're based at the front of the college. And finally, we have an incredible learning support team that are there to help with any additional learning needs, and we will discuss that with you at interview, so make sure you tick the box about learning support. Next slide, please. So hopefully I've whet your appetite and you think, yes, I'd like to come to Harlow College and be a chef. So what do you do? Well, we're already taking applications for September 2021. So go online onto the Harlow College website, or the interactive digital full-time course guide, find the course you want to do with us and click the apply button. You'll be asked to fill in your application form, which you will then send to us, and you'll receive a confirmation back with an interview date. Now, we're not interviewing till January, so don't panic if you don't get a date straight away. We will be knowing, we do want to meet you, and we know that you're there, and we will work with you throughout the process to help you start on the course that's right for you. Okay, next slide, please. There are different ways you can follow us on social media, and also if you have any further questions after this presentation. Right, let's have a look to see what questions you've been asking us. So I've got Stuart who's answering them for us. So how long is my course? All courses are 1 year programs, and there are lots of options within the department to go on to higher levels. Will I need to purchase Chef White? And Stuart has said yes. And as I said, you'll get all the information at interview and enrollment. So you can actually buy your Chef's White, your restaurant kit, as well as your knife set. How many hours work experience do I do? We usually do 30 to 35 hours. So it's a bit like working a normal week. And as I say, it could actually be spread over a whole week, or it could be 1 or 2 days each week. But we also offer extended work placement, which is for about 3 months. Okay. I'm now going to hand you back to our host for this evening, Sam, and I look forward to seeing you around college next September. Stay safe out there. Have a good.
Thank you, Alison, for that presentation, and thank you, Stuart, for being there to answer questions. Guys, our tutors are here all evening to answer your questions, so please do continue to ask them and we'll be here to answer them. Okay, we have a few moments until our next presentation at 6:20, which is for visual arts. So we're just going to wait a few more moments for any attendees that wish to join us. If you're already here for visual arts, welcome. Thank you for coming this evening. And we will begin very shortly. Hello, everyone. Welcome back if you're still with us. And hello to any new attendees that have just dropped in. This is the Harlow College Open event for visual arts. I'm Sam and I work for marketing, and I will be overseeing this open event today. And also in the background is my colleague Jasmine, who will be helping me with that. Delivering your visual arts open event will be our visual arts team. How this webinar will work is our presenters will share their information with you. They can't see you, but you should be able to see them alongside any information they wish to share on screen. Our presenters and other attendees can't hear you. However, you will be able to ask questions throughout the webinar using the Q&A feature. If you're using a computer, this will be at the bottom of your screen. If you're using a mobile device, tap the screen and this will appear at the top. Someone will either answer your questions live or answer it on the Q&A feed. Ask your questions as we go along, and we will save some time at the end of the subject presentations to answer as many as we can live. Please be aware that your name will appear next to your question, but you can click Ask Anonymously to remove this. We are recording this webinar and you will receive an email with a link to the recording. This will also be available on the Harlow College website. I'm now going to hand over to our Head of Academy, Alison, for our Visual Arts Open event. Don't forget to send in your questions using the Q&A feature.
Hello, good evening. My name is Alison Armitage and I'm Head of Academy for Leisure and the Arts. The presentation I'm about to give is for Visual Arts Curriculum Team, I'll also have Karen Harrison, who's the manager for the area, who's on the question and answer feed. Next slide, please. We offer three levels of programmes across three subject areas. Our level two art and design programme is very successful. About 80% of our students progress onto level three courses within the area. And every year we have students who start on level two and progress onto university. During the year, we build your practical skills through hands-on workshops whilst improving your communication and your time management skills, which prepares you to progress onto one of the level three programmes in the area you wish to study. Entry requirements for the level two are four GCSEs at a minimum grade of three or equivalent. The diploma and extended diploma we offer in three different subject areas. As you can see, we've got art and design, fashion and photography. You can take the 1 year diploma and progress onto the full extended diploma in your second year, which is which a majority of the students sign up for and complete the 2 year program. It should be noted that the extended diploma is equivalent to three A-levels and will take you to university if you require to go that route. Entry requirements for the level three are four GCSEs at grade four or above, and ideally include English and a creative subject. Students who have not gained a GCSE grade four or above in English and maths will need to continue with their studies, as this is a mandatory part of their funded study programme at the college. We also offer a level four professional diploma in creative enterprise and deliver this alongside the media team. It is ideal for the students who do not want to go straight to university and a good choice for students who wish to be self-employed or work freelance. Next slide, please. Students also go on to study games design, animation, fashion and business, marketing, fashion journalism, fashion photography, fine art, painting, sculpture, printmaking, theatre design, costume design, model making, special effects. There's quite a few different areas you can go into within the industry. Students obtain places at top universities such as UAL Central St Martins, London College of Fashion, Brighton, Norwich and Nottingham Trent. Local universities such as the University of Hertfordshire and Anglian Ruskin University are also very popular. Education is a popular career destination and students are employed as art or photography teachers at secondary school, but also teach in primary school or work with special needs students. Next slide, please. Course content. As you can see there is a description of what the course content is, and you'll see examples of live briefs and competitions being mentioned, and I'll talk about those later. How are you assessed though? You will be pleased to hear there are no exams. Students produce a portfolio of coursework and the final grade is determined by a self-directed project in term three. We call this the FMP, or the final major project. Next slide, please. A typical day. Full-time students are in 3 days a week for theory and practical sessions. The day starts at 9:30 and finishes at approximately 4:30, and you will have been given an individual daily target to achieve before you leave. The other 2 days will be self-study, completing assignment work. We are proud to be an Apple Distinguished College, and all students have an iPad and a variety of apps that are used to support and record their learning. Next slide, please. Work-related learning. We have close links with businesses and aim to immerse our students into industry practices to prepare them for the world of work. This includes live briefs, where a local business will approach us for students to take on commissions and in some cases earn some money. They can also be part of the assignments. Our level three students have taken part in the Royal Opera House Design Challenge, where students made 3D sets. Four pieces of site-specific artwork were commissioned for Princess Alexandra Hospital and put in place in the new reception area in the hospital. We also worked on a project with Dolphin Ward, which is the children's ward, and the photography students produced photos for the frailty ward. Last year, we ran a competition with Essex and Hearts Air Ambulance Trust to design a sculpture for their new hangar at North Weald. They were so impressed by the students' work that they commissioned two sculptures. The other one is to go at their head office at Earls Colne. Both sculptures are currently in production. Our fashion students had a great opportunity to work with Diesel. Year one students visited the head office in London and the flagship store. They took part in a fashion promotion campaign, which included fashion photography, and the winner was awarded at the college runway show. Fashion also worked with Scarlet Retro and Vintage Shop in the boardwalk, a successful collaboration of upcycling garments for resale. And our level two students run a social action project each year where they hold a Mad Hatter's tea party and reception of the college. Students take the components of the table setting, a plate, a bowl, cutlery, a cup, and they create a poster, the invitation, and provide cakes to raise money for a charity of the student's choice. Next slide, please. So, examples of students' work. If you go on the Harlow College website, we've put together a virtual gallery which showcases students' work across all programmes from last year. It's also possible to watch our virtual fashion runway show from 2020 and see examples of students' final project work produced during the first lockdown. Next slide, please. We are very proud of our facilities. We have a fashion production room with industrial sewing machines, overlocker and steamer, pattern cutting tables and professional equipment, and a vibrant fashion design studio. We have 3D workshops, ceramic studio with two large kilns, and a busy print room with presses for various types of printing. We have two professional photography studios, two photography mat suites, and a loading room and dark room for traditional photography. Each group within the team has its own dedicated base room. And in the photos, the first photo is some prints the students have done in the print room. The second set of photos in the middle are the students making components for the Mad Hatter's tea party. And you can see somebody carving out their cutlery there from polystyrene and somebody else making their plates and bowls from pottery. Next slide, please. Technology. All students are issued iPads and we use them in all lessons, both on-site and remote learning. In this picture, you can see a student use an iPad in ceramics, an area you may not expect to see technology being used. We also have two Mac suites where students use Photoshop, Illustrator, and InDesign. Next slide, please. Course costs. We go on trips. Last year, all first year level two and level three students studying art and design, fashion and photography visited the beautiful Kew Gardens for their visual research. We visit blockbuster exhibitions such as Tutankhamun, Oceana, Georgia O'Keeffe and Don McCullen. Fashion have been to Dior, Anna Sui and Azzedine Alaya in recent years. Photography have attended the Wildlife Photographer of the Year exhibition and visit photography festivals in Brighton and Rochester and make location visits such as Rochester Castle, Malden or Hatfield Forest, which are also very popular. Next slide, please. The photography students are advised to buy their own camera. And I've just put up on screen, I know you won't be able to read all of it, but you can see there's a Canon 4000D and a Nikon D3000, which are the level of camera that our students would need for the level three program. And the reason I put them up there is I thought maybe you might get some Christmas money you can put towards it, or a generous Father Christmas will actually deliver those to you. But you'll have this in the presentation afterwards to have a look at it a little bit more closely. Next slide, please. So our top tips from the visual arts team. Do what you enjoy. Take photos, draw, make and create. They always advise you in the team to have a notepad with you where you can draw things you see and take notes. Photograph the work you do in school and at home so you can create a digital portfolio, as we will probably want to see this at interview. Be aware of what is going on in the creative world. Visit online museums and galleries. Follow artists, designers, photographers on social media. Be aware of the impact of COVID on the design industries. Be extra experimental and try new things. Next slide, please. While you're at college, you may need some support. And we have the STAR Agency, who are based at the front of the college. Admissions are based there, and they're the people who you'll send your application to if you apply to us to come in September. They also offer career advice, work experience, financial and travel information. Another amazing team of ours is the safeguarding team, and they're based also at the front of the college, and they're there to support our students if they need support with their own safety and well-being. And another magnificent team are learning support, as they're there to help with additional learning needs. And we'll discuss this with you at interview, so make sure you tick the box so we can see how we can help you and make you successful. Next slide, please. So hopefully I've whet your appetite and you'd like to come and join us at Harlow. So you can apply online. We're now taking applications for September 2021. So what do you need to do? If you go to our college website or go to our interactive digital full-time course guide, find the programme you'd like to do, and you'll find a big button to press that says apply now. Fill in the application form that you will see and then send it to us. You'll receive a confirmation followed by an interview date. Now, our interviews don't begin until January, so don't worry if you don't get a date straight away. We will work with you throughout the process to help you start on the course that's right for you. Next slide, please. There are different ways you can follow us on social media, and you've got some examples on the screen now. Plus, you can also ask us any further questions you don't get answered this evening. Let's have a look to see. Next slide, please, sorry. Let's have a look to see what questions we've got. So, do you need to be able to sew and have your own sewing machine at home? Karen has an answer. Oh, she has answered it, beg your pardon. We have sewing machines here. It is great if you have sewing machines at home, but we do have sewing machines here. Are there exams on these courses? And Karen's replied, no. All our courses are graded by the final major project. So that is the final unit you do, which takes place in term three in normal class conditions. Okay. Well, thank you very much. I'm going to hand you back to Sam, our host, and I hope to see you at interview and also joining us in September. And I do wish you a safe evening. Good night.
Thank you very much, Alison, for that presentation. And thank you, Karen, for answering those questions. Guys, we do have all of our tutors here this evening to answer your questions. So please do continue to ask them and we will get to them. We have a few more minutes now until our next event, which is performing arts. So we're just going to wait for any more attendees that wish to join us. Hello everyone, and welcome to our open event this evening. We are now moving on to performing arts. I'm Sam and I work for marketing, and I will be overseeing this open event today. And also in the background is my colleague Jasmine, who will be helping me with that. Delivering your performing arts open event today will be our performing arts team. How this webinar will work is our presenters will share their information with you. They can't see you, but you should be able to see them alongside any information they wish to share on screen. Our presenters and other attendees can't hear you. However, you will be able to ask questions throughout the webinar using the Q&A feature. If you're using a computer, this will be at the bottom of your screen. If you're using a mobile device, tap the screen and this will appear at the top. Someone will either answer your questions live or answer it on the Q&A feed. Ask your questions as we go along, and we will save some time at the end of the subject presentations to answer as many as we can live. Please be aware that your name will appear next to your question, but you can click Ask Anonymously to remove this. We are recording this webinar and you will receive an email with a link to the recording. This will also be available on the Harlow College website. I'm now going to hand you over to our Head of Academy, Alison, for our Performing Arts Open event. Don't forget to keep sending your questions using the Q&A feature.
Hi, good evening, everyone. My name's Alison Armitage, and I'm Head of Academy for Leisure and the Arts. I also this evening have Natalie Francis with me, who's the Manager for Performing Arts, and she will be answering your questions on the Q&A feed. The presentation this evening is for Performing Arts and Music. In our area, we offer acting, dance, musical theatre, production, and music. Next slide, please. As you can see on the screen, we've got Super Six careers that we think our students could progress onto. But as I go through the list, you'll find it's an endless list. At Harlow College, we are about careers, not courses. These are our current Super Six careers for our pathways we feel our students can aspire to. A performer entertainer. This can be on stage, local, regional, or national. So you could be touring on TV or film. There are many kinds of performers, such as street performers, mime artists, singers, aerial performers, a cruise ship performer or entertainer. You could stream yours or other people's work online, be in a band, as a Walmart act, or for an extra in TV or Netflix productions. You could be an artist. These are people such as directors, choreographers, composers. Be a teacher or educator. So you could be a lecturer in education, a fitness trainer, a singing teacher. A therapist. You can find drama, music and dance therapists use their skills sets to help health and mind of others in the treatments they offer. You could do administration production. Front of house manager, such as directors, designers, editors, backstage crew, script writer, being a critic for exhibitions, shows, gigs, performances, magazines, radio, or a newsreader. You could be a presenter. This can cross over with media too and journalism subjects. So studying performing arts or music can lead you into these subjects at university. TV, radio, film presenter, a vlogger, a compere, a voiceover. There are so many roles, which is why our area is so varied in the skill set we train our students to achieve. Our focused and enthusiastic students are very versatile in implementing their skill set, and these can be in areas and jobs that they may not have even contemplated as a 16-year-old, and we'll use them later on in life. We call it contextualization, and it's a skill set within itself. And all of us have it in us. Next slide, please. Course levels and progression. What programmes do we offer? We offer three levels of qualification, and our awarding body is UAL, which is the University of Arts London. Our level two diploma in performing and production arts, also known as PAPA, is a one-year programme. Entry requirements are four GCSEs, grade three or equivalent. You will also be asked to do an audition and interview in your chosen pathway field, such as dance, acting, or music. And I'll explain about what is involved in the auditions in the next slide. The level three diploma, year one, an extended diploma, which is the second year in performing and production arts, PAPA, has pathways in acting, musical theatre, dance, and production arts. Entry requirements for GCSEs at grade four or above. Audition and interview in your chosen pathway. We also have the level three diploma, year one, and extended diploma, second year in music performance and production. And again, the same entry requirements are four GCSEs, grade four or equivalent and above, and an audition and interview. Excuse me. And our level four professional diploma in performance is a one-year program. Entry requirements are at level three. You need to have achieved a merit or an MMM or above. You also will need GCSE English at grade four or above or equivalent, but you will only have an interview. The process for applying for the courses, you'll apply online and details will be at the end of this presentation. But whilst waiting for your interview slot, start preparing your audition piece. Dancers, you'll need to create a solo piece that is between 1 and 2 minutes in length to your own choice of music, but you must have two different styles of dance in the solo. Actors, you'll be given four monologues. You will choose one classical and one contemporary monologue of your choice out of the four. Musical theatre students, you'll be sent the same four monologues, but you will choose one monologue that you would like to perform and one musical theatre song of your choice. Music students, you'll need to perform a solo piece of your own choice too. Information on all these auditions will be given to you when you receive your interview slot. They will be completed in your own environments and sent to us via iMovie, WAV, MP4, OneDrive or Google Links. The interview will be completed via a telephone conversation with you, and any questions you have, please ask us. Next slide, please. Our level three performing and production course is in two halves. The first year is the diploma and is equivalent to 1.5 A levels. If you stay on to complete the second year, then this is equivalent to 3 A levels, and this course links up with other qualifications into the UCAS tariff table with UCAS points given for university or higher education. And it should be noted that most of our students do the full 2 years. Typically, our first year diploma students pass and then carry on to their second year. Some students decide after their first year to transfer across disciplines, for example, from acting into dance, dance into music, or even music over to media. The UAL course allows for creativity to be honed to your ambitions. This is why it's such a unique and supportive qualification. After completing your level three program, students have then moved on to university, vocational colleges, set up their own businesses, into employment or apprenticeships. Next slide, please. Our music performance and production courses follow the same pattern as the performing arts course, but at the end of their second year, there is a pass, a high pass, a merit, a high merit, or a distinction. Typically, our students tend to go to BIM University, which is the British and Irish Modern Music University, or they work in the performances or production side of music. Whilst working, they often continue gigging throughout their lives, but with a teacher, retail or production side to their careers. Next slide. Progression and beyond. Let me talk about three of our past students. Declan Donovan, an ex-music student, who on the 26th of October this year has just hit number one in the iTunes singer-songwriter chart for Perfectly Imperfect. Well done to him. We're very proud. Ebony Clark is an ex-dance student who is currently the dance captain and swing in London's West End musical Everyone's Talking About Jamie, after previously performing with Thrill Alive. We wish all those artists who are venturing into alternative fields whilst COVID has affected our London West End theatres and the best of luck to explore their own creativity. Niall Gray is an ex-acting student and now a radio presenter for Capital Radio, and you can catch him on Twitter at Niall Gray. We are keen to remain in contact with past students as they are a real inspiration to everyone. They do workshops, talks, presentations, and discussions with us, so you may meet them in the future. Next slide, please. Course content. The level two performing and production art students infill into their chosen pathway, acting, dance, or music, and they will build on their skills and techniques in research, planning, practical skills, and reflective evaluations. This is a great course to help develop the students' confidence. It is graded a pass, merit or distinction, and in their ninth unit, there is an accumulation of all their learning throughout their previous 8 units. So there are practical and theory lessons, plus performances, solo, duos, group work throughout each project. between 3 to 6 performance opportunities, live and recorded, studio or screen, each year. Evening performances are also part of the course for all our students. Next slide, please. So let's look at a typical day for a performing arts student. Well, full-time students are in for 3 days a week for theory and practical sessions. The day starts at 9:30 and finishes approximately 4:30, and each student will be given an individual daily target they will be expected to complete by the end of the day. The other 2 days will be self-study, completing assignment work. When we have performances that you are taking part in, you will be expected to stay later. We are proud to be an Apple Distinguished College, and all our students have an iPad and a variety of apps they use to support and record their learning. Next slide, please. So work-related learning. Our links with industry are varied. We have professionals from the industry offering practical workshops and job placements. Some of the professionals we have had have been BIM and the ICMP, both of them being music universities. The Dance Network Association, they're based in Colchester and students have gone to work for them. Mountain View, which is an acting university. Italia Conti, which is a prestigious vocational acting college in London. The Central School for Speech and Drama. MGM Clinics, which is where a physiotherapist has come in and shared his knowledge to the dancers. And Elish Margotson, a street dance choreographer, came in for some dancers. And plus, as I mentioned, our past students come in who are working in the industry. We also do group and solo work singing lessons, which happen too. Next slide, please. So examples of students' work. Here you can see monologues being formed, singers, choreographed audition pieces, music rehearsals, and full-scale performances. Next slide, please. Our facilities. We're very proud of our facilities. We have 4 sprung floor studios equipped with smart boards, stereo systems, and mirrors used by actors and dancers. Our 116-seated glass box theatre caters for all performance, and it's bigger than what you think, and wow is often the first words that people say when walking into it. We have 3 music rehearsal studios, each with an electronic drum kit and acoustic equipment. Pro Tools and Logic are used for composing, sequencing, and editing. There is a Mac suite and a theory room too. Music students bring their own equipment. Next slide, please. Technology. As I mentioned, we're an Apple Distinguished College and all students receive an iPad, which needs to be charged and ready for the start of every lesson. We use a variety of apps to support our delivery and enhance our students' experience. You will need to pay £50 deposit for your iPad charger and lead, and these must be in good condition to allow your deposit to be returned at the end of the year. There is financial support via the bursary to pay for this deposit if you should need it. Next slide, please. Course costs. Creating a safe and realistic working environment for our learners is an important part of their experience. We expect all learners to come to college with the suitable clothing where appropriate, with the optional kit and specific individual equipment. Our students go on trips, visits and workshops, and the payment required will be as and when, and you will pay it into your online account, which is with WisePay. The kit is £37 and is a zip black hoodie and T-shirt embroidered with your name and the Glass Box Theatre logo. Uniform information will be issued with your enrolment packs, and that's for dance, musical theatre and acting students only. Band equipment, you will bring your own instrument and equipment, and that will include earplugs, jack leads and personal microphones for hygiene. And as I said, payments for course costs can be made through our online payment system, WisePay. An account will be set up for you as part of the enrolment process. Next slide, please. So, what are our top tips for you to being successful? Well, as our performing arts and music groups are like their own little student family, our top tips would be Be willing and open and prepared. Try your hardest at every opportunity that you're given. Give everything a go. Make mistakes, but learn from them. Improve on them next time. Politeness and manners cost nothing. And ask for help. That's what we're here for. We are your stepping stone for the next path of your career. So take every opportunity given to you. So what should you be doing now? Keep active and be creative with your mindset. Improve your flexibility, your stamina, and your muscle strength. And think of an audition piece, 1 to 2 minutes in length. Next slide, please. Student support. Whilst you're at the college, you'll probably have to have some help from student support at one point or another. We have the STAR agency based at the front of the college where admissions can be found, and they're the people who will be handling your application should you decide to join us. They also offer careers advice, work experience, financial and travel information. Our amazing safeguarding team are there to support our students if they need support with their own safety and well-being. And our fantastic learning support team are there to help with additional learning needs. And we'll discuss these with you at interview, how we can support you with your learning. So make sure you tick that box. Next slide, please. Well, if I've whet your appetite, you need to apply, and you'll be glad to hear that applications for September 2021 are now open. If you go to the college website or our interactive digital full-time course guide, find the course you want to do, you're interested in, and click on the big button that says apply now. You'll then be asked to complete an online application. You will receive confirmation followed by an interview date, but our interviews don't begin till January, so don't panic if you don't get a date straight away. We will work with you throughout the process to help you start on the right course that's correct for you. Next slide, please. Okay, if you'd like to follow us, we have some apps that you can see on the screen now. But let's have a look to see if there's any questions that have come in. We've had lots of questions. You've been typing really hard tonight. Okay, so Natalie has been answering the questions for performing arts. And it says, does this mean you can apply only one subject? For example, I'd like to do dance. Is that possible? And Natalie says, yes, you can apply for just one dance if you wish. However, at interview, if you wish to apply for another subject, we can also add these into your options. I want to study art, photography and music. Would that be possible? Just lost that one. Some of the courses you can put subjects together, but it would be something you'd need to actually ask at interview. Is it true that all students at Harlow College get an iPad? Yes, it is. Everybody gets an iPad. You pay a £50 deposit at the beginning of the year. If you don't have the £50, you can apply for a bursary. And as long as we get it back in a good condition at the end of the year, then you get your £50 deposit back. Okay, I'm going to hand you back now to our host for this evening, Sam, and I look forward to seeing you soon. Stay safe.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, Alison, for that presentation. And thank you to Natalie for answering those questions. Thank you to all of our attendees who have joined us today. We hope you've got a lot of useful information out of this open event. Our online applications are now open, so head over to our website to apply online today. We will drop you an email with this session recording, and we would really appreciate it if you could spend just a couple of minutes filling out our survey so we can continue to improve this service. Don't forget, you can also download our brand new prospectus. It's gone completely digital this year and is jam-packed full of information, videos and virtual tours. You can view and download our prospectus on our website.